Hello everyone. Today's topic is mutations. Myself, Dr. A. Madhuri, Assistant Professor of Microbiology from Government Degree College for Women, Begumpet. Today, let us learn the topic mutations. So now let us see what is meant by mutation. Mutation in a broad sense include all these heritable changes which alter the phenotype of an individual. Means mutation is a heritable change. What do you mean by heritable change? Heritable means some character which is being transferred from one generation to another generation. Okay, so mutation is also a change which can be transferred from one generation to another generation or from parent generation to offspring generation, which alters the phenotype of an individual, which alters the phenotype. Means phenotype means physical appearance of the individual. Okay, so this is the definition, or it can also be defined as a sudden heritable change in the character of an organism which is not due to either segregation or recombination. Okay, so it can also be defined as it is a sudden change which is heritable and which is not due to recombination or segregation. Segregation means separation and recombination means forming a new combination. Okay, so this is the definition of mutation. So whatever be the words, in easy language we can understand this as a some change in the organism which is getting heritable. Okay, now if we go into the brief history, the term mutation was given by Hugo de Vries. Okay, the scientist Hugo de Vries has given the term mutation to describe the sudden phenotypic changes which were heritable. So this Hugo de Vries scientist has worked on organism Oenothera lamarckiana, and he has observed some changes in from generation to generation, sudden changes, okay, that they are phenotypic changes. Okay, so to define these sudden phenotypic changes, he had given the term mutation. So it was earliest record of mutations goes to 1791, where Seth Wright noticed a male lamb with unusually short legs, development of Ancon breed of sheep. Okay, so long back in 1791, the person called as Seth Wright, he had observed some sudden changes, or he had observed some lambs with the short legs. Okay, which has led to the development of Ancon breed of sheep. So it has, that mutation has developed, resulted in the development of some new breed of sheep. However, the systematic studies on mutation were started in 1910 by T.H. Morgan. He used Drosophila melanogaster for his studies. Okay, but the experiments in a proper manner were started by the scientist T.H. Morgan in the year 1910, and he used Drosophila melanogaster for his experiments. Next, in 1927, H.J. Muller demonstrated for the first time the artificial induction of mutation by using X-rays in Drosophila. So till now, scientists were studying what are mutations, how they are happening in nature. Right, but in 1927, another scientist by the name Muller, he demonstrated how we can induce mutations by our own. Okay, if we want to bring any changes in the organism, we can induce mutations by exposing them to X-rays. And he has also worked on Drosophila. Next, in similarly 1928, L.J. Stadler demonstrated an increase in the rate of mutations due to X-rays in barley and maize. Okay, so this scientist Muller has worked on Drosophila, but Stadler in 1928 has worked on barley and maize, but he has also shown the same effect that by using X-rays, mutation rate can be increased. Next, induction of mutations by chemicals in fungus was demonstrated by R.A. Sternberg in 1939. So till now, X-rays was only used as an inducing agent for mutations. Later, in the year 1939, Sternberg has demonstrated that even chemicals can be used for induction of mutations, and he has worked on fungus, that is Aspergillus. Next scientist, Auerbach and Robson, in 1946 used chemicals to induce mutations in Drosophila. So in the year 1946, two more scientists, Auerbach and Robson, they have shown that by using chemicals also we can induce mutations in Drosophila. And the first plant breeding program using mutations was initiated in 1929 in Sweden, Germany, and Russia. So first plant breeding program. Plant breeding means production of cross between two different varieties and developing a new variety. Okay, so this cross breeding or plant breeding program was done by using mutations, that is called as mutation breeding. It was started in 1929 in the countries of Sweden, Germany, and Russia. In India, it was initiated in early 1930s. So just 1 year later, even in our country, this plant breeding program or mutation breeding programs were started. Now, first, before entering into the topic, we have to understand some basic terminology which is used in this topic. Okay, so in this list, first term is muton. What is muton? It is the smallest unit of gene capable of undergoing mutation. It is represented by a nucleotide. Okay, so muton is the, you have to remember this definition. What is muton? Muton is the smallest unit of gene which is capable of undergoing mutation. It is generally represented by a nucleotide. Next, mutator gene. A gene which causes another gene or genes to undergo spontaneous mutation. Okay, muton means it is the gene itself or it is the sequence itself which is capable of undergoing mutation, whereas mutator gene is something or it is some sequence which can cause mutation in another gene. Okay, a gene which causes another gene or genes to undergo mutations can be called as mutator gene. Next, mutable genes. Genes which show very high rates of mutation as compared to other genes. Mutable genes means the genes which are showing very high rates of mutation are called as mutable genes. Next, what is mutant? An organism or cell showing a mutant phenotype due to mutant allele of a gene. Okay, mutant means the organism in which the mutation has happened. We can call it as a mutant. Next, mutagen means it is the agent which is able to cause the mutation or induce the mutation. Okay, so it can be a physical agent or a chemical agent. Next is hotspots. Hotspots are highly mutable sites within a gene. So basically, what is a gene? It is just a sequence present on the DNA. Okay, it is a sequence of nucleotides present on the DNA, right? So what are hotspots? Hotspots are highly mutable sites. Means if in that sequence there are particular region where there are more chances of mutations. So such highly mutable sites are called as hotspots. Next, gene mutations or point mutations. Here, this can be defined as the changes which alter the chemical structure of a gene at molecular level. Okay, if the mutation is happening at a molecular level or genetic level, then we can call it as a gene mutation or point mutation. So this is the terminology. Just I'm revising once again. Muton means it is the unit of gene which is capable of undergoing mutation by itself. Okay. Mutator means this will cause mutations in another genes. Mutable genes means they undergo mutations. Mutant means after mutation, we can call that organism as a mutant. What is mutagen? It is a physical or chemical agent which can cause the mutation. And hotspots are the highly mutable sites in a gene. And then gene mutations or point mutations, the changes which alter the chemical structure of a gene at molecular level. At molecular level, if some changes is happening in at the genetic level or next is classification of mutations. Here we have to understand what are the different types of mutations or how they are classified. So mutations can be classified in several ways. First one is based on direction of mutations. Second is based on source or cause of mutation. Third is based on tissue of origin. And fourth is based on effect on survival. And fifth is based on trait or character affected. And sixth is based on visibility or quantum of morphological effect produced. And seventh one is based on site of mutation or on cytological basis. So these are all types of classifications. Okay, so let us try to learn one by one. First one is based on direction. Okay, so what do you mean by direction in case of mutations? Whether it is a forward mutation or a backward mutation. What do you mean by forward mutation? Any change from wild type allele to mutant allele is called as forward mutation. It means that one form will be wild form and the other form will be mutant form. Okay, wild form means where there is no change in the or which is naturally existing variety, that is wild type, right? And mutant type means after change in the wild type, if there is any mutation, it will convert into mutant type, right? So the change from wild type to mutant type or change in wild allele to mutant allele is called as forward mutation. Okay, next, backward mutation or reverse mutation. It means that a change from mutant allele to wild type allele. Okay, so this is the first mutation where wild type is converted to mutant type, right? If there is a second mutation, right? If there is a second mutation which is changing the mutant type to wild type, then such mutation is called as backward mutation. Okay, so based on direction, there are only two types, forward mutation and backward mutation. Forward means change from wild type to mutant, and backward means change from mutant to back to wild type. Next, based on source or cause of mutation. Source or cause of mutation. First one is, this is again is of two types, spontaneous mutation and induced mutation. Spontaneous means mutation that occur naturally. Induced means mutation that originates in response to mutagenic treatment. Okay, so spontaneous means here human intervention is not there. Mutation is occurring on its own. Okay, in nature, there was some factor which is causing this spontaneous mutation, but there is no human intervention here. or human interest is not involved here. It has happened spontaneously. Such type of mutations are called as spontaneous mutation. And the second type is induced mutation. It means that it is induced by the human. It is done by some treatment. Okay, so here this induced mutations are induced by humans because of interest. Next, based on tissue of origin, where in which tissue this mutation is happening. Okay, it can be again of two types, somatic mutation or germinal mutation. Now we are familiar with the words somatic and germinal. Just if we can revise, somatic means normal cells. Okay, germinal means reproductive cells. Okay, in our body, somatic cells means it can be a cell of our skin or liver or stomach, our hair, anything. It comes under somatic. Whereas germinal cells means in females it will cover X, or in males it can cover sperms. Okay, so these are germinal cells. Okay, so if there is a mutation in somatic cells, this mutation cannot be transferred to next generation, right? That mutation, somatic mutation, cannot be transferred to next generation because somatic cells will be limited to that organism only. They won't be transferred to next organism. Whereas germinal mutation, the mutation which is happening in a germline cells or reproductive tissues, they are responsible for formation of an offspring, right? They are involved in the production of next generation. So definitely these mutations which are occurring in germinal cells will be transferred to next generation. Next type is based on effect on survival. To what extent the organism is able to survive the mutation, right? So this classification divides the organism into four types. First one is lethal mutation, second one is sublethal mutation, third is subvital mutation, and the fourth one is vital mutation. Okay, so coming to the first one, lethal mutation. Lethal mutation means mutation which kills the individual that carries it. Okay, lethal mutation means it is a mutation which kills the individual that carries it. Lethal means killing, right? Here the survival is 0%. It means that in other words, we can understand in this way, lethal mutation means if there is a mutation in any organism, definitely that organism will die. That organism will be killed. So such mutations are called as lethal mutation, where survival rate is 0 and death rate is 100%. Coming to the sublethal mutation, that name itself shows that sublethal. Again, it is lethal but sublethal. It is not completely lethal. Okay, so when mortality is more than 50% of individuals that carry mutation, here we can understand in this way that if 100 people are infected with this mutation or 100 people are having this mutation, about 50% of them will die and 50% of the population can survive. So such condition is called as sublethal mutation. And the third variety is subvital mutation. When mortality is less than 50% of individuals that carry mutation, subvital means vital means survival. Okay, this mortality is less than 50%. Here about 50% will die. Here mortality is less than 50%, then we have to call it as subvital mutation. And vital mutation means when all the mutant individual survive. Vital mutation means here there is no problem of death in any individual which is affected by that mutation. Okay, here survival is 100% and death rate is 0%. Again, let us repeat or revise. Lethal mutation based on the effect on survival, lethal mutation, sublethal mutation, subvital mutation, and vital mutation. Coming to the next classification based on trait or character affected, means which character is affected in the organism. Based on that, again, the organisms are of two types. Mutations are of two types: morphological mutation and biochemical mutation. Morphological mutation means a mutation that alters the morphological features of an individual. Morphology means appearance. Outer appearance of an individual can be called as morphology. So, if any mutation is altering the morphology of an organism, then it is called as morphological mutation. And the next one is biochemical mutation, means a mutation that alters the biochemical function of an individual. Okay, biochemical mutation means it is the mutation which is altering the biochemical nature or biochemical functioning of an organism. Next classification is based on visibility or quantum of morphological effect produced. First one is macromutations and the second one is micromutations. In the heading itself, we can understand that it is the visibility or quantum of morphological effect, means to what extent we can see that effect of mutation morphologically. Okay, so first one is macromutation. It produces a distinct morphological change in phenotype, means it is causing the changes in phenotype to a larger extent that we can understand that change has happened just by seeing the organism. Okay, next, generally found in qualitative characters, example color of flowers, height of plant, etc. So these macromutations generally we will be seeing in qualitative characters. What do you mean by qualitative term? Qualitative means it shows the quality of the organism or character. Quality means it is showing the nature of the character. Quantity means it shows the number of the character, number of, it involves number. Quantitative means it involves number. Qualitative means it involves nature. Okay, so these mutations or macromutations are generally seen in qualitative characters, that is flower color or plant height, etc. Next is micromutations. In micromutations, invisible phenotypic changes can be seen, generally observed in quantitative characters. Okay, as the name micromutations, here it is showing that the effect of mutation is very low, that it is called as point mutations. Invisible phenotypic changes are very rare here. Based on the site of mutation or on cytological basis. So based on the site, there are again mutations are of two types: chromosomal mutations and gene or point mutations. Chromosomal mutations. The mutations are associated with detectable changes in either chromosome number or structure. Okay, here mutations are occurring in a number of chromosomes. Okay, in humans we are having 23 pairs. If means 46 chromosomes are there. If any number is changed, that 46 is changed to 45 or 47. Anything, that is a chromosomal mutation. Or not only number, if it is affecting the structure of the chromosome, if there is any truncated chromosome, right, or bigger chromosome than normal, then definitely it is called as chromosomal mutation. Next is gene or point mutation. Here mutations are produced by alterations in base sequences of concerned genes, means point mutation or gene mutation means these mutations are occurring at a genetic level, okay, or they are affecting a particular gene. They are affecting the sequence of a particular gene, right? So here in this diagram we can see this is the DNA molecule and altered DNA. Here in this section there is some problem, so that may be the mutation. Next, where, what and how to look for if there is any problem in the DNA, how to look for this problem, where it has happened and how to repair it. Next, in a chromosome, if this is the chromosome, we can see there is a break here. This can be due to mutation. This is morphological changes in mutations. Now, we have genes. We know this is the sequence of DNA, and if we check the sequence, this is the normal DNA and this is the DNA with mutations. Okay, so just to see here, if you check the sequence, in place of guanine, we are getting adenine here. Okay, and here also in place of guanine, we are getting guanine. In place of thymine, we are getting guanine. So basis, the sequence has been changed. The base sequence has been changed, which are nothing but mutations. In the previous slides, we have talked about point mutation. So this sequence CG has changed to TA. Okay, so one base sequence has changed. The sequence is changed at a single base. So such mutations can be called as point mutation. Next, coming to the types of mutations, duplication. Here, the sequence getting doubled or duplicated here. This is the sequence which is getting doubled or duplicated. That is why the chromosome length has been increased. This is called as duplication. Inversion means the sequence present in a particular area is getting inverted. It is placing in a inverted direction. Next, deletion means we are talking about chromosomal mutations. Deletion means here a particular part of chromosome is deleted. And insertion means here a new segment is getting inserted. The segment from a larger chromosome is getting inserted into a smaller chromosome. So such a mutation is called as insertion. And coming to translocation. Translocation means exchange. The part from this chromosome has entered into this chromosome, and from the part from pink or purple chromosome has entered into yellow chromosome. So the simultaneous exchange of segments, chromosomal segments, can be called as translocation. Okay, and some more changes, mutations are there. This is the normal sequence. We can call it as a BEAST, BEAST, substitution. Substitution means one base is changed by another base. Here B is changed by F. Okay, this is the substitution. So the substitution has changed the meaning of the word. Next, insertion. This is the BEAST, and one segment or one alphabet has got inserted here, which means breast. And next is deletion. If you remove A from this sequence, we will get the word best. And inversion. Inversion means some sequence has got inverted. For example, BEAST. In place of ST, if we write TS, it will become BEATS. Overall, in all the cases, the meaning of the word is changed due to type of mutation. Now, the same thing we have seen in the previous slide, we are able to see in some more detailed manner in this slide. For example, Now, in this type of mutation, if we can see, this is the normal DNA, right? This is the normal polypeptide. And first mutation, okay? This is the silent mutation. Here you can see the third base. Here adenine is there. In place of adenine, guanine has come. And with respect to guanine, in the another strand, cytosine has come. Okay, but the sequence of amino acids has not changed. If you check the sequence of amino acids, first one is phenylalanine, tyrosine, alanine, and arginine. Here also, phenylalanine is there in spite of changing the sequence in the third base of this codon. Okay, so this is called as silent mutation because even though there is a change in the gene sequence, the sequence of amino acids has not changed due to degeneracy of codon. What is degeneracy of codon? Degeneracy means one amino acid can be coded by multiple codons. So here, phenylalanine amino acid can be coded by... Next is... Here, the sequence has changed in this part of the DNA, right? Here in in place of guanine, cytosine has come. So the amino acid has changed from alanine to glycine. Okay, slightly different amino acid sequence we can see. This definitely shows the change in the properties of a protein. And the third one is nonsense mutation. Here, nonsense means nonsense codons are there. Nonsense codons means stop codons. Stop codons are coded by three bases, UAA, UGA, and UAG. Okay, so what happened here is the second codon, which is ATA here, it has changed to the sequence of ATT. Here, in response to this, here in mRNA, the sequence has changed to UAA, which is a stop codon. Okay, when ribosome is reading this sequence on mRNA, there is no amino acid coded by this sequence. So, the polypeptide chain will stop at this point where due to unavailability of tRNA carrying that amino acid for this particular sequence. That is why it is called as a stop codon or nonsense codon. And we will be getting truncated protein by such mutations. So these mutations are called as nonsense mutations. And the next one is frame shift mutation. Here, frame shift mutation can be by two processes. One is insertion mutation and the other one is deletion mutation. Insertion mutation means here the base has got inserted. Base has got inserted. If you check the sequence, triple A, then ATA is there. Okay, ATA. So in between these two codons, one thymine has come in between these two codons. So one thymine has got inserted in this sequence. So as a result of this change in the DNA, RNA will also be changed, giving the sequence UUU, AUA. So the sequence of amino acids has changed dramatically from the second amino acid. Okay, here second amino acid, tyrosine, alanine, arginine are there. In place of these three amino acids, we got isoleucine, cysteine, and threonine. Okay, so the sequence of amino acid has got changed due to insertion mutation of frame shift mutation. Okay, next is frame shift deletion. In this type of mutation, one base has got deleted from the sequence. Here, if you check AAA, the thymine which is here has got deleted. So as a result, there will be deletion in the sequence of mRNA also. So this is the resulting sequence in mRNA, which is changing the amino acid sequence to from phenylalanine tyrosine alanine arginine to phenylalanine leucine histidine valine. So there is a major difference in the sequence of amino acid, which is caused by frameshift deletion. So the same information what we have seen in the last slide can be depicted in a different format. Okay, this is the general information. Observe the first sentence. As the man saw the dog hit the can, and it is. Okay, this is the normal sequence. This is the normal gene. Now, what happens by point mutation? What happens by point mutation? Here at one base, it has changed, and by deletion, there is a deletion here, and insertion of new word, and frame shift. The complete insertion or deletion of a single letter, there is a complete change in the sequence. Next is characteristic features of mutations. Coming to characteristics of mutations, mutations are mostly recessive and very rarely dominant. What do you mean by the word recessive is? They are not getting expressed in the next generation. Okay, usually they will be recessive. They won't express themselves in coming generations, and they are very rarely dominant. Sometimes many, very few times they are expressing or they are dominant to another allele. And most mutations have harmful effects and very less are beneficial. Mostly mutations are harmful. Next, they may be due to a change in a gene or a group of genes or entire chromosome. As we have seen in the previous slides, mutation can be at a point gene genetic level, that is point mutation, or a set of genes can be changed, or entire chromosome can also be changed in some cases. If gene mutations are not lethal, the mutant individuals may survive. However, chromosomal mutations are generally lethal. Okay, if gene mutations are not lethal, the mutant individuals may survive. However, chromosomal mutations are generally lethal and such mutants do not survive. Okay, here what they mean to say is, if the mutation is at a genetic level, sometimes or mostly the organism may survive. But if it is at a chromosomal level, okay, if it is at a chromosomal level, chromosomal mutations means there will be change in the structure of the chromosome or there will be change in the number of the chromosome. In both the cases, it is difficult for the organism to survive that mutation. Many of the mutants show sterility. So as the organism functioning is affected, mostly it also affects the fertility of the organism and they will result in sterility. If mutation occur at both loci simultaneously, the mutants can be identified in M1 generation. Okay, so loci is a plural form for the word locus. So now you have to understand what is locus actually. Locus is nothing but it is the position of the gene, or it is the place occupied by a particular gene in a particular chromosome or particular DNA. Okay, it is a place or a position occupied by a particular gene. The mutants can be identified in M1 generation, means in both the loci, if mutation occurs, means DNA is a double-stranded and it is having sequence in both the strands. And if there is a mutation in both the strands at a simultaneously at the same time, that mutants can be identified, means that change in the sequence is happens to be phenotypical in the next generation, that is M1 generation. However, if it is restricted to one locus only, the effect can be seen only in M2 generation. Okay, if it is happening in only one strand of DNA, that particular mutation can be dominant or recessive, but it can be seen in the M2 generation, because in M2 generation both the strands separate from each other. And coming to the next point, that is macro mutations are visible and can be easily identified, while micro mutations cannot be seen with naked eye and need special statistical tests. Okay, macro mutations means bigger mutations, okay, which are visible and can be easily identified, means the mutations which are resulting in major changes in the organism are called as macro mutations, and these are easily detectable, right? While micro mutations cannot be seen with naked eye and need special statistical tests. So micro mutation means the mutations which are showing the effect at a micro level. Such mutations cannot be detected with the naked eye and they need some special statistical tests to identify. And next is, most mutants are of negative selection value. And mutation for altogether new character generally does not occur. So when a mutation occurs in any organism, mostly the character will not completely change, or the new character cannot come into existence altogether. Next, mutations are random, that is they can occur in any tissue or cell of an organism. However, some genes show higher mutation rate than others. Okay, so these mutations are random, means it is not decided or it is not restricted for the mutations that they should happen in a particular area or particular sequence of an organism. They can happen anywhere, any place of the organism. Next, however, some genes show higher mutation rate than others. So in the previous slides we have come across the term hotspots, right? So there will be some sequences which are more prone to mutations, higher rate of mutation. So such sequences are also called as hotspots. Mutations can be sectorial. The branches arising from mutated sectors show mutant characters. So mutations can be leading to different branches in the coming generations, and they are recurrent. The same mutation may occur again and again. Means the mutations which are occurring in one generation, it is not compulsory that that mutation is stopping in the coming generations. It is definitely going to repeat. Such mutations are called as recurrent mutations. And the next one is, induced mutations commonly show pleiotropy, often due mutation in closely linked genes. So these mutations which are being induced in organisms, they show pleiotropy. Pleiotropy means different types of mutation can be seen in linked genes. Some genes will be linked. So in such linked genes, we can see many forms of this mutation. Next, coming to the types of mutations. So first one is spontaneous mutation. The term spontaneous means sudden changes. Okay, this spontaneous mutations are occurring without any apparent cause. There are two possible sources of origin. One is due to error during DNA replication, and the other one is due to mutagenic effect of natural environment. So coming to the first type, right? What is this first type? Error during DNA replication. What is DNA replication? For the cell to divide, first the DNA has to get replicated, right? Replica means copy. Whatever DNA is present, first it has to make two copies, then the cell divides, right? So this, in this copying process or in this replication process, this is a very tedious process carried out by different types of enzymes. Okay, even then it is a foolproof process. But even then, there are chances of errors during this replication. So if there is any error during this DNA replication, definitely it will lead to mutation. And the second one is due to mutagenic effect of natural environment. Means due to environment also, there can be some effect on the genes. So that is also called as spontaneous mutation. So in short, spontaneous mutations are of two types. One is due to changes during DNA replication, and the second one is due to environment. If we take one example, UV rays from sunlight. Okay, the rate of spontaneous mutations is very low, 1 in 10 lakhs, but different genes may show considerably different mutation rates in crop plants, some varieties were developed through spontaneous mutations. Okay, so the best example for spontaneous mutations is UV rays from sunlight. When the light from sunlight is reaching the earth, there are UV rays coming from this sun, right? So this UV rays are filtered by ozone layer. Okay, ozone layer is helpful in preventing this UV rays to reach the earth. But due to human activities, there are some problems and there are some holes in the ozone layer. If by mistake, if this UV rays from the sunlight reaches the earth, what it will cause is it will cause mutations in different organisms. So such mutations are also called as spontaneous mutations, and the rate of these mutations is 1 in 10 lakhs. The rate of mutation is very low, but there is a chance of mutation. But different genes may show considerably different mutation rates. Okay, when there are different sequences for different genes, they react different in a different manner for different mutators or different sources of mutation. And in crop plants, some varieties were developed through spontaneous mutation. So in agriculture, we are using this spontaneous mutations for developing different varieties. Coming to the second type, that is induced mutation. Here induced mutation means human intervention is there out of interest. Human is inducing some mutations at a particular point in that gene sequence of the organism. Okay, this inducing of mutations is by treatment with either a physical agent or a chemical agent. The physical mutagen or a chemical mutagen. The mutagen means it is the agent which causes the mutation. Okay, it can be physical or a chemical. The exploitation of induced mutations for crop improvement is called mutation breeding. Okay, when you are exploiting these mutations, induced mutations for crop improvement is called as mutation breeding. If you want to develop more resistant varieties of crop by inducing some mutations in the crop plants, then definitely it is called as mutation breeding. And the next one is rate of induced mutations is very high. The induced mutations did not differ from spontaneous mutations in expression. Here, one more important difference between spontaneous mutation and induced mutation is the rate of induced mutations is very, very high. And the expression, the way of expression is similar in both spontaneous mutation and induced mutation. So there is no difference in the expression of genes in these two types of mutations. Now, what is the molecular basis of mutation? How these mutations are occurring in the organism, and how to change, how to see the changes in chemical structure of a gene at a molecular level? Usually the mutations at genetic level are called as point mutations. So these point mutations involve the changes in the base sequence of the gene, which results in the mutant phenotype. So these point mutations can be of three types. One is base substitution, second one is base deletion, and the third one is base addition. Base substitution means you are replacing the base. You are replacing the base. You are removing one base and you are putting another base, that is base substitution. And the base deletion means removal of the base at a particular location, and base addition means we are adding one base at that particular position. Next, coming to the base substitution, as I told you, the base is replaced. Transition, this base substitution is of two types, namely transition and transversion. Transition means if a purine is replaced by another purine, it is called as transition. If a pyrimidine is replaced by another pyrimidine, that changes is called as transition. And coming to the transversion, if a purine is replaced by pyrimidine or pyrimidine is replaced by purine, that change is called as transversion. Now, base pair changes may lead to silent mutations, missense mutations, or nonsense mutations. So, when the sequence of gene is changed, it may lead to, or at a single base, it may lead to silent mutation, missense mutation, or nonsense mutation. In the previous slides, we have seen this. This is the silent mutation where this is the normal sequence. This is the silent mutation where the amino acid has not changed. So protein won't change and the further effect will not be changing. Nonsense means the change, the codon is changing in the mRNA level, is changing to stop codon. That is nonsense mutation. And missense means the meaning has been changed. The meaning has been changed. This is conservative and this is non-conservative. Here conservative means here lysine has changed to arginine. If you compare the structure of both lysine and arginine, they are very much similar in structure. That is why the change, the first of all, it is missense. The sense is changed, but it is a conservative missense mutation because the structure of both lysine and arginine are similar in form. And it is non-conservative means it is not related anywhere to that previous amino acid, where you can compare the structure of lysine and threonine. The structure of this lysine is differing into a larger extent from threonine. So this is called as non-conservative missense mutation. And the next one is frame shift mutation. This also we have seen in the previous slides. If a single addition of a base or a single deletion of the base will result in the change of the complete sequence from that point of the mutation, that is called as frame shift mutation. Here you can see this is the insertion or addition of the base. So this, as at this point the addition is there, the complete sequence of amino acids has got changed. That is the effect of frame shift mutation. This is the deletion for frame shift mutation. Here one base is removed, that is why the sequence of amino acid from this point has changed. And the deletion mutation, missing of some nucleotides in DNA. If a part of the sequence is changed, from sequence is deleted, that such mutation is called as a deletion mutation. And if the missing part is very long, if the missing, whatever part is missing, if the deletion part is, if it is very long, or thousands of base pairs have gone, so it will be resulting in the loss of many genes. In E. coli, 5% of spontaneous mutations are deletions. In E. coli, this is the bacteria Escherichia coli, 5%. So whatever mutations are occurring in E. coli, out of that, all mutations, 5% of mutations are deletion mutations. And these deletion mutations are caused by recombination between different regions of the DNA. And this deletion mutation can also be due to unequal crossing over. What is crossing over? It is the say exchange of chromosomal segments during this event of cell division. So if the crossing over is not occurring in a exact way, or if there is unequal crossing over, then also it will result in deletion of one particular chromosome. And due to this deletion mutation, definitely genes will be inactivated, and deletion mutation can never revert back to the normal type. Here this is the deletion mutation. This part of the segment has been removed. And insertion mutation, insertion means insertion of a new sequence at a particular point. For example, the best example for insertion mutation is transposons. Okay, transposons, they are represented by IS, that is insertion sequences. They will inactivate the gene because they are going and sitting in between the gene. And they also contain transcription termination sites sometimes. And they also rarely reverse because this reversion is not possible in majority of the cases which has happened due to transposon. And the last one is tandem duplication. In this type of mutation, a sequence of nucleotides or genes are copied and transferred to another region of the same DNA. So duplication, a copy is duplicated. One particular sequence is copied and inserted into the same DNA molecule. That is called as tandem duplication. In this case, you can see the repetition of particular sequences. So that is called as tandem duplication. And reversion versus, so with this, we have covered different types of mutations. And we have started from the definition of the mutation. We have understood different types of classifications of mutations. Then we have seen the different types of mutations with examples and with diagrams, clear diagrams. So thank you for patience.